Hello friends, in the previous video we have studied that which type of instruments are necessary in the greenhouses so that we can measure the important parameters such as temperature, humidity, airflow, etc. Now we will move on the next important parameter, the next important components. So the first component is the airflow visualization. Now, for what purpose the airflow visualization is important? You know that sometimes in the greenhouses it becomes very necessary to find out the leakages, because the first and primary work that the greenhouse has to do is the entrapment of the radiation. If it is having any kind of leakage or opening present in the greenhouses, definitely it will lose out the heat. So for the optimum work of the greenhouses, it becomes necessary to find out the leakages. So for finding out the leakages, we are having airflow visualization. So to find out the leakages, we are having important devices called as the stick, gun sticks, candles, bomb formats, etc. So that it will create smokes inside the greenhouses, and just because of those smoke we can find out where are the unusual air leaks. So these are the different instruments which are very important to create the smoke inside the greenhouses. You know that the air flows from the high gradient to the low gradient. If any kind of air leakage is present inside the greenhouses, through that leak area the air will try to come inside the greenhouse. As soon as the air is coming inside the greenhouse, it will create the waves of the smoke. As soon as the waves are created over there, we can very well identify that the leakage is at that particular place. So to create the smokes, we are using these instruments. Sometimes the airspeed streamers are also been used, so that we can install these streamers at particular places, so that due to the air flow the streamers will float in the air, and as the streamers have been floating in the air, we can identify that the air leakage is present at that place. The measurement of light intensity. You know that the measurement of light intensity is the most important constraint in the greenhouses. So for the purpose of measuring the light intensity, we are having quantum sensors. These quantum sensors can measure the light having the wavelengths from 400 to 700 nanometers. This is the quantum sensors which we are using for the light intensity measurement. Carbon dioxide. The carbon dioxide can be measured with the help of portable carbon dioxide monitor. It will give the reading in ppm. This is a portable carbon dioxide monitor which can provide the available carbon dioxide in the greenhouse environment in ppm, that's parts per million.